Hi and welcome to Data Garden. Thank you for checking out my video. Today's video is the second one in my R Beginner series, and in this video we're going to cover the base plot function. So in the last video you have already learned how to load up some data that is included in RStudio. And that's also the first thing that we want to do today. So let's type data, and in brackets the name of the data set. In this case the data set is called trees. Press run. And let's actually have a look at it with the view command. Now, as you can see, it has three columns. All of them are numeric continuous variables, and they're called girth, height, and volume. And those are measurements of trees that were, I think, found in Canada. So, as I've just said, we want to create some plots now. So, let's get into it and type plot, which is the plot function in R. And for a start, why don't we try to just type in the name of the data set, it's called trees, and see what happens. Press run, and there we have a plot, and we can actually zoom it in. And as you can see, it's actually already quite clever, because R has already identified that all of the variables are continuous, and that we have three variables, and so it created a plot for us. It has 6 dot plots in total, where each one has one variable on the x-axis and one on the y-axis, so that we have each combination of x and y-axis somewhere here in these plots. For example, this one has the girth on the x-axis and the height on the y-axis, and this one has height on the x-axis and volume on the y-axis. So if you're having a new data set and you just want to get an overview at the relations between the variables, this one is already pretty helpful, and you can get a pretty good idea of the data just by using this one small command. But what if, let's say, we are only interested in this relationship between height and volume, and we don't want any of the other plots that R has given us? Let's close this window and create a new command. We call it plot again. And as you can see, R suggests us to first type in the x variable and then the y variable. So let's type x equals trees with the dollar operator height, and y equals trees with the dollar operator volume. And let's press run. And there we have it. So that was pretty easy, right? Now, one thing that you might want to change are these label names, because unfortunately R is not as clever about these as it is about analyzing the data that we are giving it. And it's giving us these names where the dollar operator is still in it and it looks pretty bad. So let's go back to our command, and just before the closing bracket, we have to type another comma. And then with the commands xlab and ylab, we can actually change the label names. So let's type xlab equals height, comma, ylab equals volume. Now, one last thing that we might want to do with this plot is to create a title for it, because right now we don't even really know what's up with it. So in R, you have the option to create a main title and a subtitle, and the commands for those are main and sub, respectively. So let's just go for main title for this one. Main equals tree measurements, and press run. And there you go. We now have a pretty good looking plot already. So that was quite easy, I think. And to get some more practice with it, let's load up a second data set. So use the command data, and this one is called iris. Now let's once again have a quick look at the data with the view command. And as you can see, it has 4 numeric continuous variables and 1 factor variable with 3 levels. Now what this data set is, it has data on iris flowers, and It is often used as a test for classification algorithms, where you feed the algorithm only these numeric variables and you try to predict which species of the iris flower it is. If you're interested in that, I recommend you subscribe to the channel, because I will make a video on that topic very soon. But for now, let's actually create a plot where, let's say we call it plot, of course, and we define x equals iris species and y equals iris sepal length. Now let's stop here for a moment and ask ourselves what's going to happen here, because we have just seen with the last plot that we have made that R has created a dot plot by default. But a dot plot would not really make sense for this situation, because species is a factor variable. So what do you expect R will do here? Let's check it out. And as you can see, it was once again pretty clever, because R has identified that we have a factor variable here and has created a box plot for us by default. So there you can see that depending on which data you feed the plot function, it will already give you pretty different plots. Now, this was quite easy again, I think. And there's one more thing that I want to show you, and that is how to create multiple plots and arrange them in a grid type of scenario. So let's actually copy this plot with Control C and Control V, or Command V and Command C and Command V if you're on a Mac, and make four instances of it. And in each case, let's just change what we have on the y-axis. So the second one we want the sepal width, and in the third one we want petal length, and in the final one the petal width. Now we can also plot them if we want, and as you can see, all of the plots are slightly different. Now if we want to arrange all of these plots in a type of grid, then we can do that with several different functions, but the easiest one might be the par function. So let's try this. I think it stands for partition. And the command that we want to use in this function is called mfrow equals, and then we have to type a vector where we first type in the number of rows that we want and then the number of columns that we want. So let's try if it works. Press run, and first plot, second plot, third plot, fourth plot. Now, let's say we want to arrange them a bit differently, then we can also type here instead of mfrow, mfcol, and as you can see, it will now arrange the plots that we're making by column instead of by row. So that was quite easy as well, I think. One more thing that I want to show you is how to export a plot, and you can do that by clicking here on export and save as image, and then you can give it a file name, iris in this case, and save, and then it will be in your R directory. So this concludes what I want to show you in this tutorial. I hope that you found it helpful. If you have, then please remember to give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more videos of this type, then please subscribe to the channel, because I have more content coming up very soon. Thank you for watching, and bye bye.